Well, you'll be moving your family to St. Louis, Missouri soon, but aren't really sure what neighborhood or what subdivision is going to be the best fit for you? Well, stick around because today we're going to be exploring the master plan community of Newtown at St. Charles. Hey, I'm Kevin Duy, a realtor here in St. Louis, Missouri, and I specialize in helping families just like yours relocate from around the world to move right here to St. Louis, Missouri. So whether you're moving in a few weeks or a few months, I'm here to help you make a smooth move to St. Louis. So give me a call, shoot me a text, or send me an email so I can get to know you and your family a little bit better. That way I can help you find the perfect neighborhood that's going to meet your needs. Newtown at St. Charles is a sprawling master plan community located in St. Charles County. St. Charles County is located just to the northwest of St. Louis County. One of the big things you're going to notice when you drive through or walk through Newtown is that there's so many different bodies of water. So right when you first pull in, you're going to be driving right alongside a canal that kind of feeds into a large lake. And there's actually three different lakes in Newtown. And so the three lakes are all stocked full of fish, so you can fish, you can kayak, you can swim, you can paddleboard, all that kind of fun stuff. My brother and sister-in-law actually live out there with my four nephews and their dog. And so we go out there all the time and just kind of hang out on the lake. It's awesome for Memorial Day parties and stuff. They have us out there for barbecues. And, we just kind of set up next to one of the lakes, barbecue, hang out, swim. They got this huge lily pad thing that goes in the water, that goes out on the lake, and all the kids can stand or sit or hang out on there. They've got some kayaks that we kayak around through and stuff. A couple of my boys love to fish, so they love doing that. It's just a really fun day out there. We always look forward to going out there and just spending some time out there on the lake. And just like I can imagine, if I lived there, I would be, kayaking all the time, throughout the lakes and the canals, because they all kind of connect to each other. So it's really, really cool and a fun place to visit for sure, and probably an even more fun place to live. My brother and sister-in-law, they built out there around 2006, 2007. It was kind of right when Newtown was just starting to get going as far as the community goes. And then, of course, when the market had a turn down around 2008, they kind of hit a lull in building for about 8 to 9 years or so. But now, it is booming out there. There's all kinds of new construction, so it's just sprawling and expanding out and growing into an even bigger community out there. And so it's kind of funny, when they first moved out there and everything was all brand new and shiny and everything, and none of the trees had matured, so all the trees were about 6 to 7 feet in height when you're driving through and everything. We always joked and called it Pleasantville or the Truman Show, because it felt like a manufactured community. It almost felt like a make-believe or fake community. But it's so different now, 15, 20 years later. It is, all the trees have matured, and so now when you drive down the main drag, when you come in, up the main strip there on Canal Street, it is, all the trees are huge, and so it's a totally shaded street when you're driving through, and just it's a totally different feel now. Now it really feels like it's an established, mature neighborhood, just because of all the big, tall, mature trees and everything, even though it still does have a lot of new development and new building going on there as well. One cool thing about Newtown is that there's a wide variety of different size houses. So you can find a 2-bedroom bungalow all the way up to a 5-bedroom house with an in-law suite attached to the back of it. You could find a lot of different square footages, different floor plans out there in Newtown for sure. So pretty much anything for every budget. So Newtown is a huge golf cart community. Walk through there, drive through there, you're gonna see a ton of people on golf carts just driving all over the place. There's always people out walking, riding their bikes and stuff. So it's a really just an active and vibrant community. There's always people coming and going. So it's pretty cool. And it has a neat community feel to it as well. So as cool as I think Newtown is, there are some things that I don't really care for. Things that would kind of bug me if I lived there. These are just my own personal preferences. You may have totally different, opinions on it. But the one thing I don't really care for is that the yard sizes. The yards aren't very big. Like Like some houses you'll see they have decent sized yards, but for the most part, especially like the houses that are, I guess, you know, landlocked or like the ones that are in the middle of, you know, the main part of the community, they're all pretty small yards. And they all have detached, for the most part, most of the houses in there have detached garages in the back. So I don't really like that fact, you know, that you have to go through an alley, you know, to get to your garage, then you have to walk from your garage, you know, across it. Even though it's a small backyard, it's not a big distance, but you still have to walk from your garage, you know, to your house uncovered. So like if it's raining or snowing, whatever, bad weather, you know, that just kind of stinks. So that's one thing. Another thing is like, you know, the HOA, like they're pretty strict. And so like, even like when you're building your house, I remember when my brother and sister-in-law were building theirs, like they couldn't pick like the exact color that they wanted. They had to pick from a certain limited number of colors on their house because they don't want like two colors of the houses being like close to each other. So like, you know, they don't want two gray houses next to each other or two red houses next to each other. So basically it's almost like a pattern where, you know, if you want a red house, but there was a red house, you know, two lots down, you can't pick a red house. You have to either choose a different lot or a different color house that you want your house to be. And so that, you know, I don't like restrictions like that. I mean, like HOAs are great as far as like keeping the community up and like keeping the community standards up and helping your property value, you know, be high. But you know, sometimes they're a little bit overbearing and cumbersome in that aspect. And so another thing that the HOA out there is really strict on is you cannot have any gas powered lawn equipment. So like if you're cutting your grass, you have to either use like a battery powered lawnmower or an electric lawnmower. And same with your weed eater and blower. So no gas powered lawn equipment out there. And so, you know, you're always seeing people out there with their little, you know, little electric or battery powered mowers, which I guess, you know, when the yards are so small, it's not that big of a deal. But you know, I don't really think that they give that great of a cut on your yard, you know? So I'm a big like yard guy. I guess if you can't tell, I like a bigger yard and I like to be able to mow the yard and have it, you know, with a regular lawnmower. But that's just me. Again, that's just me. And the other thing with the HOA is it's pretty expensive. So it's about $925 a year for the HOA, but you do get a lot of different amenities with that. You know, like I mentioned before, you know, the pool, the tennis courts, the pickleball courts, there's three different parks within Newtown and playgrounds in there. There's a lot of green space that, you know, has to be maintained and landscaped and everything out there. Then obviously all the canals and the rivers, or not the rivers, the lakes. And so they've got sand volleyball courts out there too. You know, the pools, all the different stuff and a lot of different amenities that you get, you know, in Newtown. And so, you know, obviously the more you get when you live in a community like that, the more you pay in your HOA. So, you know, there's a give and take, and it's, you know, a lot of the people that live out there find it to be a great, great value. So, you know, to each his own, but I know some people, you know, HOA fees can be a pet peeve. So wanted to make sure you were aware of that for sure. Hey, if you want more videos like this one to help you get to know the St. Louis area better for your family, make sure you subscribe to this channel and then click the bell so you're notified every single time I upload a new video. All my videos are to help you get to know about the St. Louis area better. This area right here is one of my favorite parts of Newtown. It's got a couple of different lakes and then a lot of green space. And there's this park right across the street here. And this house right here is actually one of the Whitakers. This is a Whitaker development here at Newtown. And so that's one of the owners of the construction company that created this entire community. But this park is really cool. My 7-year-old daughter absolutely loves it. You got this big elephant here, these statues, then a big giraffe over this way. Then there's a baby giraffe behind her. It's just a really fun park for kids to run. And it's like super long. Like you can see how far back that goes. Just a huge, huge area of green space. Or just, you know, playing football or soccer or wiffle ball, any kinds of, you know, fun stuff or picnics, things like that. Then over here, there's a neat little pond with a bunch of lily pads and, you know, fish in there. And then behind this pond, I mean, you just see the bikes there? Like, it's just cool. Like, you know, the bike kids park their bikes and, you know, explore the ponds and then go over to this playground back there. So there's this nice big amphitheater right when you kind of pull into town, like right at like the town hall and town square there. There's a big amphitheater and like you're going to find kids running and playing all over the place in there during the day. But then like there's also, they put on some great concerts and different performances throughout the year. And like around this whole, that town square area, every year they've got events like, you know, like Rib Fest, which is like a huge barbecue competition where they have tons of like world renowned and world champion barbecue companies and competitors come in. You know, you can buy a ticket and you go around and you sample all the different barbecue and everything. And so that's a really fun event. You know, they've got different reggae concerts out there and just all kinds of different concerts from every kind of music you would ever want. So that's always pretty cool. There's always something to do, always something going on out in Newtown for your family. If you like this video on Newtown St. Charles and think that it might be a good fit for your family, make sure you give me a call, shoot me a text, or send me an email. That way I can help you learn even more about Newtown, and more importantly, I can learn more about your family so I can help you find the perfect house on the perfect street in the perfect neighborhood that's going to meet your family's needs right here in the St. Louis area. Take care.